mind out.
When I came back from OSU, I was playing football up there 1 year and got hurt and came back to go to school here at OU and decided to start a band. I guess that's what, 4 years ago. And we started out playing gospel music mainly and any private parties we could get. Band eventually went into country music. We started at the Roadhouse. I think that was our first country job that we had. After the Roadhouse, we went to Buckaroo's. That was our next, that was our big move forward. We played there for, I guess, a year and a half or so, and off and on.
Here's a song for all the old Buckaroo's fans.
Thank you.
moment's at hand. It's a chance of a lifetime, and a lifetime of chance. It's high time you joined in the dance. It's high time you joined in.
Okay, we had Danny Herbst on piano, Hank Hobbs on bass, Mike McKelvey on drums, and myself, and Mike Crane on guitar and banjo. Janie's the only member in the band right now that started with me. Everybody else evolved through the last 3 years. We picked up Phil Holt after the band had been together about a year and a half, and he took over as our sound engineer and manager and really got the ball rolling for us as far as progressing as a band. Bob French, we talked him into joining a couple of years ago. He was playing bluegrass music around, and that was a big plus to get him. Dave Coe came rolling into town one day and said he was going to be living in Norman, and you know, he'd been with Michael Murphy for a while, and when he said he was looking for a job, we jumped on that pretty quick. Jimmy Herbst is probably our, no, not our newest, second to the latest addition to the band. We're real fortunate to have him. He's been playing with a lot of people for the last about 20 years now. He's only 22, I think, 20, so we've been playing since he's about 2 years old. But he played Ray Wiley Hubbard and a lot of different people, so we're real fortunate to have him. And then Steve Grunder is the newest member of the band, I guess. He plays bass guitar. He used to play with Blue Rose Cafe and the Medicine Park Band. He's a super bass player.
I want to introduce to you a guy that you probably already know. Most of you are familiar with him from the old Buckaroos days. But since he asked me to, I'm going to introduce him again. Now, Dave's a super guy. He's been touring on the road with Michael Murphy for years now. And people always ask us, why did he quit Michael Murphy and come with you? We pay Dave everything we make to keep him with us.
Money. It's a simple answer. Money.
Anyway, on fiddle, alto, sax, and he's going to sing you a song right now that's going to require a lot of your help, a lot of hand clapping. Mr. Dave Coe. Come on now, this is fiddle music. Everybody.
I'm going down to Austin, Texas. I'm going down to
save my soul. Eat that barbecue and chili, eat my fill and come back home. I'm gonna take my baby with me, we're gonna have a high old time. We're gonna eat till we get silly, sure to make a beer taste fine. Oh, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Oh, my mama, set your belly back on thumping. Oh, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking good? Oh, my mama, eat it every day if I could. No man who cooks armadillo tastes so sweet they call it pie. I'm gonna learn to make panduzzi taste so good it'll get you high. Eat them enchiladas greasy, eat them steaks chicken fried. Sure do make a man feel happy with a little white gravy on the side. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Whoa, my mama, set your belly back bone bumping. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking good? Oh, my mama, eat it every day if I could, yeah. So good. Since we're talking about that Texas cooking, I'm going to do a little bit of Texas fiddling. This is one called Sally Was a Good One. Testify, Dave, testify.
Oh, I feel the spirit tonight, John. I'm kind of hungry.
Yeah.
You know, I know place that's got fried okra beat anything I ever saw. They got a man that bakes those biscuits, they ought to be against the law. Get yourself a big old sausage, big old plate of ranch-style beans. We gonna eat the heart of Texas, we gonna need some brand new jeans. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Set your belly back bone bumping. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking good? Whoa, my mama, eat it every day if I could. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Whoa, my mama, set your belly back bone bumping. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking good? Whoa, my mama, eat it every day if I could. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Whoa, my mama, set your belly back on bumping. Whoa, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking good? Whoa, my mama, eat it every day, oh, if I could. Dave Cole. Right, yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. We just got back from Nashville, and we came back with a few goodies, but the main thing is we got us a record contract finally after 4 or 5 years working around here in Oklahoma trying to... This next song we're going to do is one that we did out in Nashville. We had about 4 minutes to perform for each performance, and this is a song that they said won the concert for us. The band got together about a week before the state contest and wrote the song. It's called Take Another Chance. So you say love let you down. Girl, you're just a beginner. When you lose your love, it hurts to get burned. Someday you'll come out a winner. Take another chance on love. Let's put our hearts together. We've been there before, why not try it once more? Maybe it'll last forever. Take another chance on love. Living alone ain't easy. Don't hide your love behind a broken heart. Take another chance on
It was very easy with this band, especially with John. John has always had the attitude of, I'll do whatever it takes to be successful. And with that, it's very easy to work with somebody that all they want to do is get better.
We're going to do a song that a friend of ours from right here in Norman wrote, and we've grown real fond of this song. We hope to record it someday. Somebody doesn't get a hold of it first. It's called Love Over Lonesome. It's written by a guy from Norman, Oklahoma named John Hadley. I like eggs over easy, gravy over bread. I like staying overnight, feeling overfed. I like talking over something. Laughing over wine, and I'll take love over lonesome every time. I like jumping over fences, stepping over lines. I take working over welfare, double overtime. Take nickels over pennies, dollars over dimes. And I'll take love over lonesome every time. Yeah, I'll take love over lonesome. I've had them both before. I don't care if I'm never lonesome anymore. It ain't hard to choose between. I made up my mind. I'll take love over lonesome every time. Yeah, take it. With moon over the tree, I take top over the bottom, front over behind, and I'll take love over lonesome every time. Yeah, I'll take love over lonesome. black boots over my feet, hat over my head, overcoats and overalls and mirrors over bed. I like your hair over my telephone, your lips over mine, and I'll take love over lonesome every time. Yeah, I'll take love over lonesome, I've had them both before. I don't care if I'm never lonesome anymore. It ain't hard to choose between the two, but I made up my mind. I'll take love over lonesome every time. Yeah, I'll take love over lonesome, love over lonesome, love over lonesome every time.
I heard on the radio from KXY they were having a big Wrangler Country Showdown, which appealed to us at first just because of the Dodge van. They were going to win a Dodge van. Our van has just about had it. So we thought, well, let's give it a shot before we go out and buy a new one. And it turned out we couldn't enter the one in Oklahoma City because I was getting married on the date of the finals. So we went to Paul's Valley and entered the preliminaries there. And from there we went to Tulsa to the state finals and competed against the 10 finalists around the state, different preliminaries. And won the Dodge van, $1,000, and then suddenly a trip to Nashville entered into it, which in the back of my mind we were really wanting to do, but hadn't really thought about it much until we actually got it. And then we went to Nashville, and we're hoping to get in the top 10 of the thing. You know, if we'd get in the top 10, it would really help our bookings. We'd get good publicity out of it. We'd be on national TV. And so that was kind of our goal when we went out there. And when they announced that we were in the top 10 that night, we went backstage and started thinking, well, if we could get first place, it would really help us even more. And it worked out that way. We were sure surprised as well as thrilled about the whole thing. But just the odds, the odds are so much against it, we really hadn't thought about winning first place until we actually heard our name being announced as the winners.
We're going to do another song that a friend of ours from Norman wrote. We've got a lot of friends in Norman that write songs, and this is another one that we hope to record in the near future. His name is Kevin Welch. He's out in Nashville writing for Tree Publishing right now, and he's doing a real fine job at it. He just recently had a big hit with Gary Morris with a song called Velvet Chains that I bet you recognize the title of that. But this is another one that he wrote that nobody's recorded yet, and hopefully we will. A song called Crazy Winds. Days are through.
hurt someone before the night is through. Somebody's gonna come undone. There's nothing we can do. But everybody wants to touch somebody if it takes all night. Everybody wants to take a little chance and make it come out right. There's gonna be a heartache tonight, a heartache tonight, I know. There's gonna be a heartache tonight, a heartache tonight, I know. Yes, I know. Some people like to stay out late. Some folks can't stay out that long. Go home now, there's too much going on. This night is gonna last forever, and last all summer long. Sometime before the sun comes up, that radio is gonna play that song. It's gonna be a heartache tonight, a heartache tonight. Hurt someone before the night is through. Somebody's gonna come undone. There's nothing we can do. Well, everybody wants to touch somebody if it takes all night. Everybody wants to take a little chance and make it come out right.
As we got into the contest, we realized was that Wrangler, once you got to the state level, Wrangler had really gone out of their way to make sure that the judges were legit. You know, they were involved with the music business. They knew something about it. It wasn't just somebody they picked at random to see which band they thought was the best. They really knew something about the music business.
They had to be able to look past the 4 minutes. You know, you had 4 minutes. Any band could go home, rehearse for a year and a half on 4 minutes, and come out and look great. They had to be able to tell whether the musicians that were up there were capable of doing this for an hour and a half or just 4 minutes. I think they did that real well.
It's a song I wrote up in Jackson Hole, Wyoming a few years ago. There's a full moon hanging over the city. I could swear it's watching over me. There's a north wind blowing through my window, reminding me of where I want to be. I hear the sound of dancing water, dancing to the rhythm of the stream. Something is burning inside of me, like I'm lost in a high country dream. High country dream, like an old memory that won't let go. High country dream, remind me sometimes slow in old high country dream. When the evening comes after a long hard day, the stars begin to fill the sky. I remember leaving my home in the country, and all night I stay up passing high. When the reason for the sunrise, just another day, living is just something that I do. I get this feeling inside of me, like I'm lost in a high country dream. High country dream, like an old memory, won't let go. High country dream, remind me sometimes slow high country dream, like an old memory that won't let go. High country dream, remind me sometimes slow in those high country
national prizes, or the national finals prizes, were the $50,000, which was real appealing to us. You get to keep the van that we won at the state level. Instead of just getting it for a year, we get to keep it, keep the title to it. We won a grand piano, a Kimball grand piano, Gibson, I think it's a 345 guitar. We won lots of Wrangler clothes to get us through the year. And also the biggest thing to us was a record contract with Complete Records in Nashville. And we signed with Top Billing Booking Agency in Nashville. So there were a lot of different prizes.
We just got back from Dallas, where we did the Cotton Bowl Parade and also played, opened the show for Johnny Rodriguez at Billy Bob's Texas down there. We're going out to Denver Monday to do a show with George Strait and Ed Bruce at the Denver Stock Show. Then the end of this month, going to Nashville for the airing of the Wrangler Country Showdown Finals. It's going to be on the 29th on Nashville Network. We're supposed to be down there for that, as well as the next day they're going to be on Nashville Now, TV show there. We're playing the 31st of January at Stockyard Restaurant or Cafe. I don't know which one it's called, but it's the major show place in Nashville that a bunch of the stars own. Then we're back out to Nashville later that next month to record what'll be our first 45 on complete record to be released nationally and distributed by Mercury Records.
Well, it'll be through the Polygram Mercury.
Polygram Mercury, yeah, I think.
They're going to send us out to Nashville for Fanfare, which is a big gathering of all the big musical groups and solo acts and stuff out there, where they have booths and everybody presents their material and what their future outlook is. So we'll be out there for that. They've got us at some of the major rodeos around the country throughout the year. I think one of them is the Big Cheyenne, Wyoming rodeo, which is a real big deal up there.
Doing a lot of the state fairs for the same type of thing that we were entered in, where it'll be the state finals. They want us to come and open the show so that the people that are there and competing can see who won last year and maybe give them a little fired up about the contest, that sort of thing, as well as I think they're very interested in using our equipment and lighting.
Thank you. I've been with John, like he said, since the beginning of the band, the forming of the band, and try to help in the band, not only with playing and so forth, but helping by writing chord charts and figuring out chord progressions and things like that for the songs.
It was a real incredible thing getting into this band, because I've been playing quasi-professionally for about 20 years, really, and I don't know, I was on the road all through my 20s, and which was wonderful. It was a great learning experience. And
but we got together, got married in June, 7 months ago today, and we've had a lot of fun. It's fun getting to travel together, to get to go to these places together, and especially play music together.
How's the contest going to
take
July?
Oh, so far it's the money has been great. It's allowed us to do a lot of home improvements and things like that for our little home. And as far as winning goes, it's, you know, it's just an inconceivable thing that just happened. It's kind of, it's still kind of a dream world, you know, knowing that we have done it. Just the job that we've done for Wrangler so far have been a lot of fun. And we're looking forward to that real full year doing the shows for Wrangler. And
remember those beautiful nights. Don't count the rainy days. Thank you very much.
Something that me especially, having started out in the band with John and going from playing church Valentine parties and banquets and things to our first experience as far as moving from that into clubs and actually being paid for it and trying to move into a professional sense. It's something I know John has really dreamed for a long time. And same with myself, just because I've worked with him to reach that goal for 4.5 years now. It's also become a dream come true, just because in being with this band and growing with it and so forth all these years, that kind of achievement is something that every musician, the longer you're in it, the more serious you get about it, it's something that you want to become a reality. And so for my own personal self, I'm just so thrilled about it. It really is like a dream come true.
I'm Steve Grunder. I play bass in the group.
And I'm Bob French. I play guitar and banjo and sing some backup vocals. I joined this band about 2.5 years ago, I think. I started out by sitting in with the band when the band that I was working with wasn't working, which was a lot of the time. And it was so much fun, I discovered that John had a really big following here in town, and you could go and play with this band and play to big crowds of people that liked you a lot, and that had a certain appeal.
Well, it's been a really great experience for everybody. The band and everybody involved and all our friends are really happy for us, but I would like to say that one really nice thing is that we've really been surprised at how well Wrangler and all the people at Wrangler have treated us. Everywhere we go to do a job for Wrangler, be it Dallas or Nashville or Denver or wherever, they put us up in nice hotels, they cover all our transportation, and just treat us excellently, and it's been a really great experience.
The only person that you haven't seen on the show today is Dave Coe. He plays fiddle and sax and sings lead vocals in the group and background vocals. And he's doing some session work in the city at a studio up there, so he couldn't be here. I know he would have wanted to be here, but he's making money, so he's happy.
Let me introduce the band to you real quick. You want to know these guys. I know a lot of you already know them, but on lead guitar, banjo, and background vocals, probably the most versatile musician we have. He, Bob French.
Thank you very much.
On percussion back here, one of the finest two percussion rhythm sections that I think you'll ever hear. On drums, Mr. Jimmy Herbst. On bass guitar, Steve Grunder. Yeah. Fiddle, alto, sax, and vocals. Been having trouble with this guy all week, ever since the Redskins beat Dallas. He's a big Redskins fan, but matter of fact, I owe him some money. Dave Coe! On piano, synthesizer, and all kinds of percussion and vocals, Janie Herbst. Last but not least, our audio engineer, manager. He'll arrange and produce a lot of our stuff. He was in the studio all week last week, making sure that our tape came out just right, the tape that we made that's for sale after the concert. Mr. Phil Holt, back here at the DJ booth.
And let me just do a small introduction here.
No, not after
this,
that game.
People do ask me how come I got here after playing with Michael Murphy, and it's to play with this guy here. I think he is a great musician, John Arnold.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Once again, thanks for coming out. We're going to do 2 or 3 more songs for you before we have to quit, and don't forget the tapes and pictures and everything we got back there in the back on your way out. And if you haven't signed up for our newsletter, grab somebody with an Oklahoma Audio t-shirt on, or I was going to say grab my wife. Don't grab my wife. Leave my wife alone, but just ask her for a card if you would.
She came to me, said she knew me, said she'd known me a long time. And she spoke of being in love with every mountain she had climbed. And she talked of trails she walked up far above the timberland. From that night on, I knew I'd ride on West Carolina in the pines.
Sure want to thank everybody in Norman and Oklahoma City, well, all over the state. People came to our concerts and really meant a lot to us to fill the place up and helped us to put on the kind of show we wanted to put on as an appreciation thing to everybody for supporting us for the last 2 years. Like I said, it meant a lot to us and we appreciate it very much. Mm-hmm.
afraid to love somebody, or be ashamed to show you care. Take time to love somebody now. Love is all we have to give. It's the only way to live. Take time to love somebody.